Hey everyone, what's up? My name is Nathan, welcome to Hail. I'm here with my good friend,
Hi.
Nicholas, at Barnes & Noble, but this year I have a special guest, a third one.
It's not
a
me.
Second one, I mean, because yeah. There's three of us. A second special guest. We are here with Bernardo, the movie geek.
Hi.
This is amazing. Bernardo's from Texas. All right, he's here from Texas, visiting Utah, and worked out really well. We're all doing the Criterion sale together, so we're going to bring you along with us. We're really excited.
And it's about time.
It's about time. This is a lifelong dream here. Right, let's see what we can do. So, we're going to share our definites with you. Flight of the Phoenix. That is my definite today.
Yeah.
Absolutely getting that. Bernardo, how about you?
Miracle in Milan.
Miracle in Milan. Okay, cool. Yeah. Nicholas?
I don't know, but I'd like Jodie Comer and Killing Eve.
Anything on the collection with James Stewart has to be owned by me, even if it's a movie I don't like. Support James Stewart. He needs more in the collection. Like, Cary Grant has like 50 titles. James Stewart has like 3.
I do like James Stewart, but I do, you know, I love Cary Grant.
You prefer Cary Grant.
Yeah, I do.
It's fair. It's actually not fair. It makes no sense.
There's just something about him. He's like the Idris Elba is like the new Cary Grant in my opinion.
This is on the Peter Bogdanovich challenge, but I don't like the cover because it looks like it's a bootleg. Doesn't that look like a bootleg cover?
Quality. It does,
just doesn't look good to me. It never has. Never will.
500 Days of Summer. This is what this movie reminds me of.
Today we're doing something where Bernardo's choosing a movie for me. I'm choosing a movie for him. We're choosing a movie for Nick, and we're all doing a little cycle thing. Nick, are you choosing a movie for me?
Yeah.
Nice. So we're still paying for the movie ourselves, but it's being chosen for us. We don't like it, we can just sell it on eBay. Yeah. That's what I do.
Is this the year that Nick makes Nate get sallow? Stay tuned.
Don't.
It's not gonna happen, so you don't have to stay tuned for it. You can leave right now if you want. It's not happening. Charles Lawton.
What is that one called? Is that the island?
Yeah.
That one always looks like a zombie film to me with the cover.
It basically is. He has like creatures he creates. What else do you have in there? I thought about 40 Guns before.
Was this a good movie? Did you like it?
It's a great movie.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
Show them what you're talking about.
I'm talking about Night to Remember, or as Nate Hale likes to call it, the movie that he always looked at for years and
never bought
it, and then he finally did.
Yeah, so it's a really good movie, actually. So I'm kind of sad that I've seen it and that I own it, too.
Yeah.
I still call movies Night to Remember when I don't get them. All right, you can stop filming for a minute. All right, everyone, without spoiling our picks, because we know that's a very big deal. Also, for your nice to know, anime is 20% off. These are our piles. So we've got my pile right here. I have, I think, 7 titles.
That's my pick for you. Oh my gosh, dude. Oh my gosh, this is my pick for you.
100%, dude.
That's not my pile.
I can't believe I actually found a movie you haven't seen that I have seen. I'm actually pumped. Dude, I'm actually pumped for you to watch this.
Okay.
I'm pumped for you to watch this.
He's happy, I'm happy.
All right, where was I?
Yeah.
This is my pile of movies I might get. Nick's, and then Bernardo's, which Nick aggressively just added a new movie to.
Which I'm actually really excited about, because literally I was like, Bernardo's seen everything I've seen. And then I go, wait a second, I see a movie that I love that Jackson
Being John Malkovich. Yeah, oh yeah, Jackson's been recommending that for years.
Because that movie's
amazing.
Sorry,
Jackson, I haven't watched it still.
I love that movie, and I was so surprised Bernardo hasn't seen it. And I was like, okay, this is my pick then. Like, nice. 100%. Like, dude, it's a
5/5 movie.
You're gonna love it.
It's really good. It's a really good movie.
La 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 la, just looking at Criterion's. Oh, Nate, do you have something to say?
Yeah, I was just looking at this movie. This looks like a Nathan Hale type of movie if I saw one. I mean, it's like, you go through these movies, it's like, this kind of looks like a Nathan Hale movie. Like, this, probably not. But it's like, you could kind of
Even the Day Trippers, idea. I think Day Trippers.
Day Trippers kind of looks like your type of movie,
I'd say Dance Girl Dance.
And then the mischievous guy who kills people.
We still don't know that that's the plot. I still haven't seen it, so I can't confirm.
Here's shopping criteria with Nathan Hale, and you want to recommend him something. You look at the cover and you go, does it look 60s? Okay. Does it look...
50s, 40s, 30s?
Yes, does it look 50s, 40s, 30s?
I mean, look at this.
Okay.
Not to spoil anything, but this is one I'm considering because I just love that cover. And plus, the title's hilarious.
Oh, yeah. That is a Nathan Hale cover. I'm surprised you haven't even bought it yet.
I'm never going to watch War and Peace because it's a long movie. 422 minutes.
Oh, my word.
So, Jabberwocky, this always has been my night to remember for the long time.
Have you ever seen it?
No.
But it's your night
I've
to remember.
Always been
I see.
Interested in that one too.
I think I would agree. I think it's also a night to remember for me.
It looks kind of like horrifying. That's
isn't
why
it
I
Terry?
Like it.
Oh, it's Terry Gilliam.
In my high school, when the teacher read the poem to us, I was like, I'm love.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
then we saw John Hurt doing the poems of Jabberwocky.
Okay. Elliot's made like 5 recommendation videos, and
I think
need
this
more.
Is one of the coolest Criterion things that they've done ever.
Isn't that
I might just put that in my pile just because I think it's so.
Wow, cool. Look at that. That's what I'm doing with Merrily We Go to Hell.
I'm gonna get it.
Don't give into it. Don't give into your night to remember. I'm so anti getting your anti night to remember.
Yeah, I was.
Hello, Barnes & Noble workers. Please, no filming. So we are at our second Barnes & Noble bookstore for the day. And funny enough, I thought I would be coming here to just like grab 2 titles.
Yeah.
My possible pile is bigger than the last one we went to. I have 8 movies here.
About what you said about me not being able to share a feeling. I was afraid that you'd be afraid if I told you that I was afraid of intimacy. If you don't have a problem with my problem, maybe the problem simply codependency. Say you were wrong to say I was wrong about you being wrong when you rang to say that the ring was the wrong in the ring. If I meant what I said ring for me. I feel bad that you feel bad. When I reacted to you, I'm not mad. You got mad for nothing. If I were you, what I done, what I done, I do what you did when you made me the ring. Man, said what I said. But now it's out in the open. Now it's 4 a.m. and we have therapy tomorrow. It's too late to screw, so let's just get some rest.
All right, everyone, we are home from the sale, so we want to show you what purchases that we picked up. Bernardo got 16, I got 9, Nicholas got, I just called you Nicholas, Nicholas got 6. So what we're going to do is, since Bernardo has the most, he's going to share 2, and then we'll each share 1. We're just going to go from there. As usual, going in order of spy number. Take it away, Bernie.
The first title I picked up is Summertime, starring Katharine Hepburn. Yes, please, because I love her. To death.
Also, Spine 22.
Yeah, Spine 22, and thought about David Lean, who did Lawrence of Arabia and the Bridge over River Kwai. We decided to watch this. And this is Spine 54. This is a documentary for all mankind. This is the 4K release that just came out recently.
Oh, they have that in this pile.
Yeah, sure.
Nick put that in my pile. Nick put it in my pile without me knowing.
This is a film that I've been interested in a long time, so it's about time I picked it up. Thankfully it got released on 4K, so why not get it right now? So, yeah.
All right, my first criterion is number 30. This has been on the collection forever. I've heard of it. I even started it a few years ago, but I never finished it. Don't ask me why. It is Fritz Lang's M.
I'm shocked you have not finished this movie.
Yeah, I really like Peter Lorre as an actor.
Oh, so good.
He's really good at playing the villain. Really excited to watch it and actually finish it this time. And plus, it just feels like it's a necessity for
please
the collection.
Please finish it. Please.
So, yeah.
This is my
I'll do you one better. I'll start it from the beginning.
Okay. Yeah. You heard him.
Take it away, Nick.
I did not pick up Sallow.
There
popular,
it is.
Popular request.
A little introduction. We mentioned this in the store, but each of us chose a movie for each other. So when we get to that designated movie, we will say who chose what. So, yeah. Nick?
So, designated movie. This was picked by Nate. Spy number 133, The Vanishing. It's disturbing and haunting, and I'm excited for that because I love all of that.
It has a crazy cover, too.
It's pretty cool. It's honestly like a really cool cover.
It's a great cover, disturbing movie. The reason I recommended it to Nick is because Nick loves horror movies. And I wouldn't say it's on the surface like the best horror movie ever or anything, but it's very realistic in what it accomplishes, and it's very scary by the end of it. Like, it has probably the scariest ending to any movie I've ever seen, which I know is a bold statement, but it's the reason I haven't even purchased it, because I just don't have a desire to rewatch it. So
I love the line where it says, "An unorthodox love story and a truly unsettling thriller." So like, an unorthodox love story, I'm all for that. So hopefully there's some really creepy, like, hopefully there's some good uses of tension. Horror films in the 80s are
It's probably my favorite decade of horror, to be honest.
This one I'm kind of looking forward to seeing is Straw Dogs, starring Dustin Hoffman. So yeah, this is the film directed by Sam Peckinpah, who did The Wild Bunch.
Cool.
Yeah, so that's had me intrigued, and also I heard it's one of the most riveting movies, so that's had me intrigued. Also love the cover, so yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing this one. This one I'm actually really excited to watch. This is Spine 507, Bigger Than Life. Directed by Nicholas Ray, who did In a Lonely Place, which just blew me away. Yeah, this had a very intriguing cover. This is one another And Night to Remember titles, because the cover always intrigued me, and I finally picked it up because I was so impressed with one of his films, In a Lonely Place.
Nice, dude. The next one I have is under Spine 100. It's spine number 43. It is Lord of the Flies. I've known of its existence forever. However, I just read the book. I finished on 4th of July. I don't know why I share that fact. But it's a very unsettling story, and I love survival tales. And so that's why I wanted to read it in the first place. Plus, it's referenced in Lost, and I love Lost. So I wanted to pick up the Criterion. Hopefully, it's as good as the book, and it's just completely horrifying.
My next one is...
I'm excited for this.
Who cares about this? No, my next one...
I low-key recommended this one also.
Yeah. But... The Night of the Hunter, you kind of sold me with a documentary that's like 2 hours
plus long. The supplements are worth it alone.
Which I'm actually excited for.
Yeah.
And also the sticker that says in collaboration with UCLA, I think that kind of sold it too. I don't know why. Nate's talked about this movie a lot and kind
of
forced it into my pile.
The next title is for William Hurt, who recently passed away. I really want to check out more of his roles that he had done.
Oh, don't watch The Big Chill.
Okay, cool. Good to know. Broadcast News. This is Spine 552. It's also starring Alba Brooks and Holly Hunter.
Albert Brooks.
Great cast.
Marlon.
But yeah, this just looks so interesting and very something I'm going to get into. Especially how relevant it is today with the whole broadcast news, the whole rumor, you know, the gossip and all that. Looks interesting, so we look forward to seeing for more William Hurt films that I have not seen yet. So yeah. And this one, Nick is so excited for it.
I recommended it.
Yeah.
And Jackson recommended it to me.
So this is a big blind buy. I have not seen it. This is Spine 611, Being John Malkovich.
This movie
started by Spike Jonze. This is another Criterion that I have been interested in because of the cover. The cover's always just caught my attention. I don't know, the eye. It just looks so cool.
One of my favorite numbers of all time is number 57 because the year 1957 is like the best year for movies ever. The reason I'm saying all this is because it's spine number 57. It is Charade.
Really,
and this is
movie.
The movie. Yeah, this is the movie that Nick recommended for me. The irony behind this is that I recommended this to Nick like 2 years ago.
It's a great film, yeah.
Yeah, I recommended it to him 2 years ago. I didn't own it in the collection because I owned the Best of the Decade series copy of it. I just sold it and I needed this, so I finally have this in the collection. Oh, it's a great movie, by the way. I love it. I have only seen it once, but I plan to rewatch it now that I own it.
It's almost feel like a Hitchcock movie, even though it's not directed by Hitchcock.
I love this movie. I have seen it. It's Spine 776, and it's Moonrise Kingdom. I really like this film. It's been in every time I go, I feel like it's always in my pile. So this is not my favorite Wes Anderson, because my favorite Wes Anderson is obviously Fantastic
Mr. Fox.
And I love Grand. It's hard because like Moonrise Kingdom and Grand Budapest Hotel, they're like kind of like tied for second.
Oh, so good.
Colorful like Wes Anderson.
This was the first Wes Anderson movie I ever watched.
Me too.
Yeah,
me too.
It was
the first Wes Anderson film I've ever seen.
I really enjoyed it.
They need to release Isle of Dogs. I know that's what Bernardo's waiting for.
I'm hoping.
I don't know
why they haven't.
This year I've been getting into more westerns because that's a genre I have not gotten into a lot. So this one is started by John Ford and also Henry Fonda. I'm like, yes please and yes please. That's My Darling Clementine. This is Spine 732. It's a western and that's all I can say.
It
looks great. Henry
you
Fonda.
Haven't seen it.
Nope.
It's a really chill movie. Like there's no crazy big action scenes or anything, but just having Henry Fonda. And that scene just kind of sums it up. He's just a very kind of like reserved new sheriff. Doesn't even carry a gun with him. It's just a good time.
I'm here for a good story. I just don't need an action. This one, I love the spine on this. So this is Spine 795, Gilda, starring Rita Hayworth, but also, is it Glenn Ford? Yes, Glenn Ford. Who is incredible in 3:10 to Yuma. This looks great. This is the big blind buy. I just don't know about it. I just heard that Glenn Ford's in it. I'm like, yes. And also the spine Oh, it's love pink. The spine.
It's a good spine.
Yeah, it's just all pink. Just,
yeah, that's a good spine.
It can stand down in my collection.
So the next movie for me is Spy number 435. I'm gonna
and
be
then White
about...
Chicks is the best movie, better than this one. You can rent it off or buy it off of the Apple TV for a good price, and it changes your life, and it makes you laugh. It's probably not culture accurate today, but it's still pretty good. It's anyway, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and Nathan's also single, so.
Ladies.
Was that a high five? Yeah, so speaking of White Chicks, The Furies, I love the packaging. I love that it comes with a book. I have a new love for Westerns after I did my season 3 of 25 Movie Challenge.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also Anthony Mann, he's a great director. I'm actually not that big of a fan of Barbara Stanwyck as much as other people are, crazy enough. That's good. Yeah. I've never seen, she's never been bad in a movie I've seen her in, but I just don't like her as much as everyone else. It also has a supporting actor, Thomas Gomez. Very underrated. I don't expect any of you to know who that is. However, he's in 2 episodes of The Twilight Zone, and I love those episodes. And he's in the other Criterion, Ride the Pink Horse, and I love him in that movie. So, very underrated actor, and anytime I see he's in a movie, I have to watch it.
All right, my next one, I got it just to spite Nate. Not really to spite him, but just because...
It's been in my pile multiple times and I've never purchased it.
Which is awesome because now I actually have something.
He has that on me.
Well, it's because in the future if we recommend stuff to each other,
you can finally recommend. Yeah, exactly.
That I can recommend if I like it. Spy number 955. Also, it just sounds really, really good.
It does.
It's called Panique. It's like a thriller essentially.
Isn't it kind of like a whodunit?
Well, okay.
Not a whodunit, but like he's accused of a crime he didn't do, right?
He's freaking out. He gets framed for a murder.
Sounds like The Hunt.
He gets framed for a murder. I love this line. It says, like, the tensely noirish Panique exposes the dangers of the knives-out mob mentality, delivering as well-appointed allegory for the behavior of Duvivier's countrymen during the war. I'm guessing that's the director. Never heard of the director before. It's a French film. It's from 1946.
Ooh, that's a good year for
movies.
And
I am very excited to watch this. And I think when I watch it, I will be nice, and I will come over, and I'll watch it with Nate.
In my film class, I think it's an editing class I took, the film professor showed the opening scene of this movie and just had me intrigued ever since. I don't know why I haven't, watched the entirety. That is Robert Altman,
that's
The Player.
I've seen a scene from that.
He's seen
probably
the
same scene.
Yeah. The opening?
Yeah, the opening.
I love the cover so much.
I know,
that's
I love the cover too.
Screen Criterion.
I believe it's starring Tim Robbins and also Whoopi Goldberg and others. Well-known, actors.
Whoopi.
Yeah.
Whoopi.
Whoopi. I'm no longer a film student. I just graduated. It's just right up my alley because it's take place in a film studio. This is by 827, Macabre and Miss Miller. Another Western. But I heard, from what I heard, it's a very different, unique Western film, like very dreamlike.
That was on Cinefix's top 10 Western movies.
Yeah.
Bernardo chose this next one for me. This is the one that Bernardo chose. It's Spy number 756. Now, this movie is one that I've been wanting for years. However, I haven't purchased it because it's a movie I'm saving up for. And what I mean by that, let me just show it to you. It's Limelight. One of my favorite covers in the whole Criterion collection. It has always caught my eyes.
Just look at it.
Oh, we're doing this?
Puppy eyes.
All right, cool. The reason I've held off on watching this is because I feel like I need to see as many Chaplin films as I can, just because I know what the plot is about, and I think that watching a lot of his movies and then going into this will make me enjoy this a lot more. So I'm really excited. I'm glad you recommended this one.
Oh, yeah.
So good
it's
taste.
A great
137
one.
Minutes, never mind. I'm just kidding. Just kidding.
This director has made one of my favorite films of all time, 12 Angry Men, and it is Sidney Lumet, and it is Failsafe.
So good.
I don't even really need to know the back, just I know that I'm going to like it because Nate has never really kind of swung and missed when it came to...
Hey, thanks. Criterion recommendations.
But I'm actually really excited because I think this is like a... You would say it's like a thriller, right? Doesn't it deal with like time?
It's suspenseful. Yeah. Time is definitely important. Like the clock is ticking.
And it's a black and white film, which is cool. I think
also, Henry
like
Fonda is
the
president of the United States in the film, so...
Yeah, that's cool.
So this is another Night to Remember title that Jabberwocky. Jabberwocky is one of my favorite poems by Lewis Carroll. I don't know what to expect with this film. Another Western, this has been a Western theme, 40 Guns, starring Barbara Stanwyck. I just heard good things, so.
And it's 1957. It's always a win.
Yeah, and this is by 954.
Cool, my next movie.
Oh.
Gosh dang it.
Well, it's the disc too. Oh well. Okay, so my next movie is actually one that Bernardo also bought. It is Gilda. The reason I bought this is solely for Glenn Ford. He's just been kind of a breakout star for me this year. I watched him in 310 to Yuma. I saw him in Blackboard Jungle. And I rewatched Superman, saw him as Pa Kent in that movie.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Yeah, saw him in Jubal, another Criterion you should watch. But anyways, I think he is an amazing actor. The fact that he was never nominated for an Oscar is insane and shows what a joke the Oscars are. Forget Rita Hayworth, it's all about Glenn Ford. All right, Nick only has one more, so I'm going to share another one, and then Bernardo's going to share another two.
I'll just sit back here and chill.
911, this is a Criterion that is not new to me at all. I see it at the collection. I actually picked it up this time and read the plot. And it just like hit me more than probably any other movie I bought today. And that is Spy Number 911, The Hero. Basically this movie, this man is on his way, he's on a train to go accept an award. And while he's there, someone sits down, starts interviewing him, and it leads him to kind of have a self-examination of himself and his life. I've never seen it, but that just sounds like my kind of movie. I love the cover art so much too. So I'm probably most excited about this of any of my blind buys today.
So this is Spy 979. This is a film that Nate recommend me.
Yep.
It looks so much fun. Something I'm gonna get into. That's Screen Time.
Yeah.
Starring Fred Astaire.
And Ginger Rogers.
And
Can't
Ginger
forget Ginger Rogers.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is a musical, right? Just
yeah. Cool. It is.
I'm excited.
There's a very catchy song, and the dancing is incredible. And I've never liked Fred Astaire too much. Yeah. He always just kind of comes off as cocky to me in the movies I've seen him in. I liked him in this, and Ginger Rogers is a dream. All right, so my next one is Spy Number 1114. This caught my eye because it is directed by Leo McCarey, who Bernardo pointed out directed Make Way for Tomorrow, a Criterion I love. And also 1939 is one of my favorite years for movies.
Yeah.
It is Love Affair. It's a newer release, and I know that this is the original An Affair to Remember. So just everything that's going for it, it should be a movie right up my alley, and I hope I enjoy it as much as my expectations are going into it.
Yeah.
Have you seen that? I can't remember.
Yeah, I've seen it. It's really good.
Nice.
I got it during the flash sale.
Okay.
This is a Martin Scorsese picture, and this is Spy 1118. This just also came out a couple of months ago, that's The Last Waltz. So this is a concert documentary film, so I don't know about the band and stuff, but it's a Martin Scorsese film that I want to see, because I also want to complete his entire filmography. Looks really intriguing. This particular title is my biggest difference in this July sale. This is the film done by Vittorio De Sica, who is a filmmaker, directed by Bicycle Thieves and Umberto D. Both films impressed the heck out of me and blew me away, especially Bicycle Thieves. That is Miracle in Milan. This, I just don't want to go in, know nothing about this one. I just want to go in blind and just watch it for myself. The cover is amazing. Really, really excited for this. Just,
nice.
Yeah, looking forward to this one.
This is Spy Number 1033.
Oh my gosh.
And it's Buster Keaton's The Cameraman.
Oh.
Bernardo, is Buster Keaton your favorite?
Yes.
Silent film.
Yes.
Center?
Harold Lloyd.
I've only ever seen one silent film in my life.
Which one?
Gold
I know
Rush.
Which one, but for
it's,
them.
It's yeah, Gold Rush.
It's Gold Rush.
And so I do kind of want to start getting slowly into silent films. Not
you better.
A ton, but we're going to get there slowly.
He's better.
And I've never seen a Buster Keaton movie. I have seen scenes, though. Is it him or Harold Lloyd who did The Big Giant Clock?
That's Harold Lloyd.
That's, right,
that's Safety Last.
That I want to see because...
Oh, that's... Harold Lloyd's the
Harold
best one.
Harold Lloyd is funny. Like, that was really funny. I saw that in my film class.
And in Hugo.
Great movie. Love The Cameraman. So good.
Cool.
My last movie is going to be a little anticlimactic because I told you it was my definite at the beginning of the video, but it's Spy Number 1116. That is The Flight of the Phoenix with Jimmy Stewart. It's a good thing I opened this because it came with a plane. Just like the movie, it crashed. So, very true to the movie. I'm happy to own this. This was a definite from the day I saw its release. Like, it's great.
It's a good movie.
It's a good movie, but it's not. It's far from his best.
Yeah.
But still get it if you like survival tales. I just think it's a tad too long. 142 minutes, you
could
have shed at least 20 minutes.
They could cut out some bit.
Yeah.
Great cast, too. Lastly but not least, I was tempted to get it. I wasn't sure I liked the movie. I didn't love it. But you know what? Why the heck not? This is fine. 1,134. This just came out recently, last week.
that is Raging Bull. I liked it. It's not great. I really want to revisit again so I can have a new appreciation. But all in all, good, great performance all around. All
right, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today. It's been a blast having Bernardo and Nick here. And we'll probably never go shopping again. So you guys got the finale. I don't know. I don't think Bernardo was telling me he's never buying a Criterion again after this. So. Yeah, anyways, true. On that note, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.
It was fun. Will I ever see you on YouTube?
Come on, sing
again?
Along with me.
What's that from?
That's my end credit song. You don't know that?
Oh, I mean, I haven't watched. I mean, yeah.
He's like dancing with me.